Hello, hello. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to your Monday virtual pub quiz with NYC Trivia League and Quiz Night America. My name is Meredith. I'm going to be your host this evening. Thank you so much for being here tonight. I hope you all are doing well out there. We really appreciate you checking out tonight's game. We're going to be playing four rounds of trivia. If you play with us twice a week, you know the drill. Stay tuned. We'll get to that first round shortly. If you're checking out the game for the first time here this evening, come play with us. You're welcome to join. And this is where you can get your fully interactive answer sheet. quiz.nyctrivialeague.com. Once you get to that website, you'll notice we're looking for some basic sign-up information from you. That includes a team name and email address. And then there's a drop-down menu in which you can let us know if you are or are not a part of the league. If you're wondering what it means to be a part of the league, essentially, it means we keep track of your scores every single time you play, and at the end of our league season, you will be invited to participate in our virtual King's Cup Tournament of Champions, which is going to be taking place on Sunday, September 18th. Mark your calendars, everyone. We would love it if you could participate on that Sunday. Exact start time, we will announce at a later date, but I hope you can join us. So join the league tonight. It doesn't hurt to, even if it's your first time playing. You can see your scores over at nyctrivialeague.com/standings, or you can play super casually here tonight. No pressure to be in that league. So get your team signed up by filling out those three items and clicking that join game button. As I mentioned, we are playing four rounds of trivia tonight. The first three of those rounds are going to be question and answer rounds. And our fourth category is a picture round. Each of the themes tonight are going to have 10 questions within them. For these question and answer rounds, the majority of our game, I will be asking you the questions out loud, and you will be able to see the questions written out on your virtual answer sheet. So you can see what I'm asking. Some of those questions will have multiple choice options. The vast majority of our questions this evening are going to be short answer. So enter in the response that you think is correct, and then please make sure that you click the button that says submit answers before your 20-second countdown timer expires. Keep an eye out for that countdown timer. It'll sneak up on you from time to time, so make sure you always click submit answers in the right amount of time. In the event that you should spell something incorrectly as part of your answer, I don't want you to worry about that too much. We do have a great system in place to handle such things. The wonderful Trivia Peter is working behind the scenes here this evening, and he will make sure that if you deserve a point, you get that point. Thank you, Peter. We appreciate you. Our first round is coming at you all in just a moment here. If you're just joining us, hi there. Welcome to tonight's virtual trivia event. I am Meredith from NYC Trivia League and Quiz Night America. And this website here, quiz.nyctrivialeague.com, is where you can get your fully interactive answer sheet. Please fill out those initial items on that page. Click the button that says Join Game. You will be joining the likes of 27 teams joining us from New York City and across the country and the world, even for that matter. And we're going to find out tonight who's going to take that top spot. Welcome all. That fourth and final round this evening is going to be a picture round, which by its nature will function a little bit differently than rounds 1 through 3. I will explain in detail how that final round is going to work when we get to that point of the quiz. Before we get there, though, there are two simple rules that I ask that you follow for the game. Rule number one, there will be no cheating in trivia. Do not look the answers up tonight. If you want to look the answers up, do that in your own time, and kindly do not fill out an answer sheet. We understand it can be really tempting, but refrain from doing that because It ruins the game for everybody, including yourself. Rule number two, please do not give away the answers in the chat. We love hearing from you all in the chat. Good evening, the Helsinki Syndrome. A boy named Sue, cheers to you as well. And music notes to Trivia Peter. And go Lark Team from Jive, Ohio. What is up, Lark Team? Happy y'all are here tonight. We're going to get into our first round of the evening in one moment. It's your last chance to get that answer sheet signed up for the game before we get started. quiz.nyctrivialeague.com is the place to be. You will be competing against 31 teams. Our first team to get signed up, the Helsinki Syndrome, down to our most recent team to sign up, O Trivia Rodrigo, and every team in between. We welcome you all to tonight's quiz. Best of luck, everybody. Our first category this evening, we're talking about Partner Up. Partners, duos, things that go together. Partner up, everyone. Round one, question one. This identical duo appears in Lewis Carroll's Alice Through the Looking Glass. Name that duo. That identical duo in Through the Looking Glass are Tweedledee and Tweedledum. In any order is going to get you the point there for number one. Our second question of the night. What filmmaking duo had their directorial debut with 1996's Bound before delving into science fiction like Cloud Atlas or Jupiter Ascending? Name that filmmaking duo. That filmmaking duo, I would say best known for The Matrix. It's the Wachowskis. Your correct response for number two. Our third question of the night, a different kind of partnership for this one. Fill in the blanks. A protein and a starch are basics of a meal, which is the basis of the phrase blank and blank, which is used to mean simple fundamentals. I hear my grandma might be out there playing on a team here tonight. If that is so, hi, grandma. Thank you for being here. I hope you know some answers. If not, have some fun. Your correct answer for number three, that protein is meat. That starch is potatoes. Meat and potatoes is what we had in mind for your answer for question number three. Question four, who was Bill Gates' business partner with whom he co-founded Microsoft in 1975. Oh. that co-founder of Microsoft, along with Bill Gates, a childhood friend of his. It is Paul Allen. Allen, your correct response for number four. Our fifth question of the night. The 2022 Netflix series Partner Track follows a young idealist trying to climb the ladder in the elite world of what sort of business? This young idealist is aiming to be a partner in a law firm. Law offices, law firm, your answer for question number five. Our sixth question of round one. What 2008 Katy Perry song presents many different word pairs like in and out, up and down, wrong and right? Name that song. You're hot and you're cold. That's the name of the song. You're yes and you're no. You're in and you're out. You're up and you're down. Wrong and right. That's your answer. Hot and cold. Our sixth question was hot and cold. Our seventh one, what twin brothers are American tennis players and one of the most dominant doubles pairs of all time? Those twins and American tennis players are Bob and Mike Bryan. The Bryans, your correct response for number seven. Our eighth question in our partner up round. Jen Hyman and Jen Fleece are business partners who in 2009 founded what e-commerce platform on which users can borrow or buy designer apparel and accessories? That e-commerce platform is Rent the Runway. Our ninth question of this round. What artist performed the duets Ain't No Mountain High Enough with Tammy Terrell and It Takes Two with Kim Weston? Duetting on Ain't No Mountain High Enough and It Takes Two is Marvin Gaye, your correct response for number nine. And our final question of round number one, for half a point each. What two journalists were the first to break the story of Richard Nixon's attempted cover-up of the break-in at Watergate Hotel? Name those two journalists. Those two journalists who broke the news of Watergate, the cover-up of it all, are Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein. Woodward and Bernstein, your answers for number 10. It went well for you. More of you coming in with a Woodward than a Bernstein, but pretty evenly matched here, which brings us to the end of our first round of tonight's game. I very much hope everyone is having a fun time, whether you're in these top teams or not. We currently have a humongous tie for fourth place. These teams have only missed 1 point thus far. We Drink and We Know Things 420, The Rubber Yokes, New Popes, Werewolves, Gravy at the VMAs, We Drink and We Know Things 12, The Blue Shells, Team Cockroach, The Next Irritation, We Drink and We Know Things 17, J&J, We Drink and We Know Things 69, and Team Cockroach. And tied for first right now, these three teams got perfect scores in round number one. 10 for 10, 2 for the drinks, 2 for the snacks, pieced it together. And We Might Know Stuff impressively played to all of those teams. And if you weren't in that group, we have so much game left to go. 3 more rounds. So good luck, everyone. It's going to happen. Before we get to round number two, we do private events, everybody. If you're looking for something to do for a personal gathering, maybe there's a birthday party coming up and you're looking for a way to celebrate in a special fashion, we'd love to be a part of it. Consider sending me an email, meredith@nyctrivialeague.com. We also do corporate events. So if you help to organize things for your work, think about bringing us in. We can do things in office or at venues all around New York City and the metropolitan area in general. We'd love to be a part of it. And we continue to do these virtual events. So if you're not in New York City, we can still do something with all of you. Keep us in mind for your next event, meredith@nyctrivialeague.com. Round number two, everybody. It is in the theme of brought to you by the letter B. All of your answers in this round are going to have a word within them that begins with the letter B. Let's do it. Round two, question one. What band that told us to roam if you want to, maybe roaming for the last time themselves in 2022 as they embark on their farewell tour? Years after the release of their first studio album, The B-52s are on their farewell tour. B-52 is your correct response for number one. Question number two, Benito Antonio Martinez Ocasio is a Puerto Rican rapper and singer, better known by what stage name, who won the 2022 VMA for Artist of the Year and played the character Wolf in the 2022 movie Bullet Train. Name that person. Gravy at the VMAs. I hope you got this one. Your correct answer is Bad Bunny. Bad Bunny. Our third question of round number two. In 1995, the government of India officially changed the name of this city in English from what to Mumbai? 97% of you got Bad Bunny. In 1995, it became official that what we now call Mumbai was no longer Bombay. Bombay is what we were looking for, like Coach Gordon Bombay. Our fourth question of round two. Based on a 2000 biographical fiction novel by Joyce Carol Oates, in what 2022 movie coming to Netflix does Ana de Armas play Norma Jean Mortensen? Ana de Armas is playing Norma Jean Mortensen, aka Marilyn Monroe, in the movie Blonde. That's right, you've been legally blonded, everyone. Blonde is the name of this movie that I believe is like borderline NC-17. I don't know, maybe they cut some stuff. Like Ana de Armas, I hope it's excellent. Our fifth question of round number two. The New York Yankees have what alliterative nickname, which references their home borough and their propensity for hitting home runs? The Yankees have the nickname the Bronx Bombers. Bronx Bombers, your correct response. Helsinki thinks a very easy question. Let's see if the percentage reflects that. It does indeed. 97% of you coming in with a correct answer. Bad Bunny, Bronx Bombers. Well done. Question number six, coming in 2023, is a movie about what Mattel doll, directed by Greta Gerwig? I like to hear that. We've got Margot Robbie playing this character, and Ryan Gosling and Simu Liu playing versions of Ken. Barbie is your answer for number six. I am so curious about this movie. I really want to see what Greta Gerwig's take is on this one. Yet again, 97%. We're calling it a social. Let's see if we can stump some of you with number seven. Divided amongst Malaysia, Brunei, and Indonesia, is this third largest island in the world in terms of land area that goes by what name internationally? Your correct answer for number seven, that third largest island in the world behind Greenland, and I believe New Zealand, is that the other? No, I don't know. Who knows? Oh, New Guinea? Yeah, I think New Guinea is number two, but this one, the answer is Borneo. Borneo is your correct response. Let me know in the chat if you think New Guinea is number two. That feels right to me, but I'm not 100%. Peter's saying Australia. Sure, if we're talking islands that are also continents, I don't know. Depends on the rules here. Question number eight: Amanda Stenberg, Maria Bakalova, and Pete Davidson are the stars of what 2022 horror comedy film? Yes, the metric for that question was about the land area. Madagascar is a really good guess. I do think New Guinea is number two. Peter did just post a list of those largest islands if anyone is curious. An answer for number eight, they star in Bodies, Bodies, Bodies is the name of that movie, which is supposed to be really good. I would like to see it. Our ninth question of round number two. John Turturro starred as the title character in what 1991 Coen Brothers movie about a 1940s playwright hired to write scripts for Hollywood movies? What's that movie called? Your correct answer, that Coen Brothers movie starring John Turturro is called Barton Fink. Barton Fink is your correct answer. Hope you knew that one. And to add to that, starring in that movie as the character Ben Geisler, a producer, none other than
Shalou.
Tony Shalhoub, also a star of Barton Fink. Our final question of round number two. Please fill in the blank. The Higgs blank has been dubbed the God particle, as it is central to our understanding of physics and may have caused the Big Bang. The God particle, aka the Higgs boson. Boson, your correct response for number 10. That's the B word we had in mind. 85% of you got that one right. And that brings us to the end of round number 2. Things have changed in our standings, but we do still have a giant tie for second place. These teams have 19 points. Gravy at the VMAs, We Drink and We Know Things 12, 17, and 69. The Blue Shells, Team Cockroach, The Next Irritation, 2 for the drinks, 2 for the snacks, and Team Cockroach. This is where things got a little different. In the lead right now, all on their lonesome, with a perfect score, pieced it together. 20 out of a possible 20 points. Well done, pieced it together. Our third round coming at you all in one moment. If you haven't done so recently, please check out the standings for the entirety of season 51 of NYC Trivia League Virtual Edition. You can find them at nyctrivialeague.com/standings. There are all kinds of fun metrics going on over there. Like you'll see in column 3 over there, how many times has your team finished in the top 3? How many times in the top 10 this season? These are the teams that are currently in the top 10, and I will say there are so many of you who are right on the edge of breaking into the top 10 of season 51. I encourage you, check it out. It's very cool how everything breaks down over there. And, you know, we just generally appreciate you all for playing with us, and congrats to these top teams. Reminder, we've got our next King's Cup Tournament of Champions coming up on Sunday, September 18th. Y'all are invited to play so we can officially crown the top team of this season. Let's get into our third round of the night. Symphony and orchestra is our topic. Round 3, question 1. Though piano is the name of a musical instrument, the term piano, when used in sheet music, instructs the performer to play how? Piano is asking one to play quietly. Keep it down. Play it piano. Pianissimo. Our second question of round number 3. Perhaps the most famous of a canon in classical music, what overture, composed by Peter Tchaikovsky, is named for the year in which Russia defended Napoleon's invasion? This year also saw the beginning of a years-long military conflict between the U.S. and the U.K. Name that piece of music. That composition by Tchaikovsky is called the 1812 Overture. That's the one. Question 3. A vibraphone is a musical instrument that would most likely be found in which section of the orchestra? A vibraphone is essentially tuned metal bars similar to a steel marimba, and you can find one in the percussion section. Percussion, your answer. 85% of you got that one right. Our fourth question in round number three, composer John Adams premiered an opera in 1987 called Nixon in what country? Which details the former president's historic visit in 1972. Name that country. That opera is called Nixon in China. China is your correct response for number four. Our fifth question of round number three. What Polish capital's airport is named after noted composer Frédéric Chopin, who was born roughly 30 miles from that city in 1810? Name that city. An answer for number five, the capital of Poland is Warsaw. Warsaw's airport is named after Chopin. Our sixth question of this round, considered one of the greatest symphonies of all time, Heroica was composed by what composer in 1803, nearly 5 years after he first noticed difficulties with his hearing? Eroica, composed by Ludwig von Beethoven. Beethoven, your correct response for number six. Our seventh question of our symphony and orchestra themed round. F. Murray Abraham won an Oscar for playing what Italian composer and contemporary of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart? Although he and Mozart were portrayed on film as bitter rivals, their feud was likely heavily dramatized or even non-existent. Good old F won an Oscar for playing Salieri. Antonio Salieri, your correct response for number seven. This one was my hint of the night on Instagram. I hope you all did a little digging about the movie Amadeus or thought about what you maybe remembered from that movie from seeing my hint at Trivia Meredith. check it out. I do give away a hint every single time we bring you a new quiz. The next one coming at you on Wednesday. You can find us right here the last day of August in 2022. And that quiz is going to get started at 8 o'clock Eastern time. I hope you check it out and follow me. I'll help you out just a little bit for that next game. Our eighth question of round number three. One of the big five of American orchestras, the New York Philharmonic, performs at David Geffen Hall in what Upper West Side performing arts complex? Name that complex. The New York Philharmonic plays at David Geffen Hall, which is part of Lincoln Center, is what we had in mind for number eight, Lincoln Center. As Peter mentioned in the comments here, not only do we have our virtual quiz on Wednesday, but following our virtual quiz on Wednesday, stick around. The movie quiz is back, everyone. Make it a trivia doubleheader on Wednesday. We'd love it if you check it out. play.themoviequiz.com immediately after our Wednesday game. Our ninth question in round number three. In Sergei Prokofiev's Peter and the Wolf, French horns are used to represent the wolf. The clarinet is used to represent the cat. And what double-reeded instrument is used to represent the duck? The duck in Peter and the Wolf, represented by not a bassoon, but an oboe. Oboe, your correct response for number nine. And our final question in this category. Then we've got the picture round to close us out. The modern harp, featured in orchestras, normally has seven pedals and how many strings? These multiple choice questions, always a bit of a mind game. If you went with 47 strings, you got that one right. Harps, a modern harp, 47 strings. They're just the most beautiful instrument, a harp. Well done to those of you who got that one right. 62% coming in with a correct response. Going into our final round of the evening, we've got a tie here between five teams in fifth place with 28 points. Gravy at the VMAs, We Drink and We Know Things 12. The Blue Shells, Team Cockroach, The Next Irritation, and Team Cockroach. Tied in second with 29 points, We Drink and We Know Things 17 and 69, as well as two for the drinks, two for the snacks. In first right now, they continue, excuse me, to have a perfect score. 30 out of a possible 30 points. Pieced it together in the lead right now. We shall see if they can hold on to that top spot in our final round of the night. Down at the bottom of your answer sheets, everyone, we do have these donation links. This game only exists due to the generosity of our players. If you're able to contribute a little something here tonight, it means a whole lot to us. I don't know how to express it beyond that is just the truth. It shows us that you care about what we're doing and encourages us to continue this game in a virtual platform. I really enjoy hosting for you all twice a week, and I hope that you enjoy playing with us on Mondays and Wednesdays. Let's keep it going, everybody. Just a small amount. Think of it as a tiny buy-in for playing with us, and pay our writing staff to keep the quiz alive. Thank you so much for being here. Our picture round this evening is in the category of famous Marys. In this round, you are going to see 10 images of famous people who have the name Mary. It is your job to name the person based on their image. I will be displaying those images up here as part of the live stream. They also are embedded directly on your answer sheet page. The entirety of this round is short answer. After our 10th image, we have a tiebreaker question to close out the game. Here is image number one. Please name this famous Mary. I had the great honor of meeting this Mary one time when I was a coat check person at a restaurant. She asked me where the bathroom was, and I said, it's over there. It's Mary Kate Olsen, your correct response for number one. Image number two, please name this Mary. Oh, 100% of you got Mary Kate Olsen, by the way. We are looking for the name of the character. Reminder, everyone, the category for this round is famous Marys. The name of the character, please. Yes, it is Molly Shannon, but the character is Mary Catherine Gallagher. Our third question of the picture round. Please name this Mary. Hoping for a social on this one. It is Mary Tyler Moore, your correct response for image number three. Our fourth image in this round, 97% got Mary Tyler Moore. We've seen with Mary Kate Olsen that we can get a true 100. So I'm holding out here. Name this Mary. For image number four, wonderful actress, it is Mary Steenburgen. Your correct response, image number five. Please name this Mary. The band is Peter Paul and Mary. Her name, Mary Travers. Your correct response for number five. Definitely a little tougher there. Image number six. Please name this Mary. Image number six, this is the incomparable Mary J. Blige. Your correct response. Image number seven, name this Mary. Maybe you know her from 10 Cloverfield Lane or Brain Dead or Birds of Prey, Scott Pilgrim. It's Mary Elizabeth Winstead. Your correct response for number seven. Image number eight, name this Mary. Thank you. author of Frankenstein. It is Mary Shelley. Two more images in this round, then we've got that tiebreaker question to close us out. Here is number 9. Please name this Mary. This one, we confess, it's tricky. I didn't know that her real name was Mary. It is Mary Tipper Gore. Tipper Gore, also an acceptable answer here, or simply Gore. But yeah, her first name, Mary. And our final image of this round, after which we have that tiebreaker question, which as always is going to have a number as an answer. And your goal in placing your response to the tiebreaker question is to guess as closely as you can to the correct number, meaning you can guess over or under the number. Whoever's closer is going to break that tie. Here it is. Name this Mary. Image number 10, we have Emily Blunt as Mary Poppins. Your correct answer for our final image of the evening. We're moving into that tiebreaker question, everyone. First, though, let's see if this one was a social. I hope it was. I know you're like, where is Julie Andrews, the original Mary Poppins? But even so, we know Emily Blunt is also excellent. You all got it right. The tiebreaker question this evening. First of all, this is amazing. We had Simon Timone, and someone requested last week that we had Garfunkel and Pumbaa. Ask and you shall receive. Thank you, Peter, for these amazing graphics. Let's check out that tiebreaker. Please give us your best guess. How much money did the 2018 Disney movie Mary Poppins Returns make at the U.S. domestic box office? You know, the three iconic pairs, Simon and Timon, Meredith and Dante, Garfunkel and Pumbaa, we're all together here in this very special moment. An answer for you all, Mary Poppins Returns at the domestic box office made $171,958,438. if your team ended up in part of a tie here this evening, we will figure out what happened with your tiebreaker responses, and we'll post the results on our Instagram at NYC Trivia League as soon as we are able to do so. So keep an eye out to see what happened here tonight. Reminder, everyone, this game is only here because of your generosity. Please consider a donation this evening. Oh my goodness. Zazu and Oats next. Love it. All right. I don't know. It's really, we're going into total nonsense zone here, but I'm for it, everybody. We will be back on Wednesday for our next quiz at 8 o'clock Eastern time at quiz.nyctrivialeague.com. Afterwards, please stick around for the wonderful movie quiz over at play.themoviequiz.com. Let's check out our final scores for Trivia Monday. Coming in a tie for 19th place with 31 points, Why I Oughta, Short Bus, Catman Don't, and The Helsinki Syndrome. Tied in 15th with 32, The Rubber Yokes, New Pope, Avis and Bobo, and We Might Know Stuff. In 15th place, also with 32 points. Oh, that's you. We Might Know Stuff. In 13th with 33, Swearwolves and J&J. In 12th with 33.5, Bouncy Boys. Tied in 10th with 35, We Drink and We Know Things, 420. And The Question Marks in 9th tonight with 36 points. Gravy at the VMAs, tied in 4th with 37. We Drink and We Know Things, 12. The Blue Shells, Team Cockroach, The Next Irritation. And 2 for the drinks, 2 for the snacks. Also tied in 4th with 37 points, Team Cockroach. We ended up with a 3-way tie for first tonight. All of these teams finished with 38 out of a possible 40 points. We Drink and We Know Things, 17. We Drink and We Know Things, 69. And pieced it together. Congratulations to those teams and everyone. Thank you all so much for playing. I hope you had a wonderful time. I've been Meredith from NYC Trivia League and Quiz Night America. Thank you so much, Peter, for keeping things running nice and smoothly behind the scenes here tonight. Thank you, Cullen, for making this game possible. And thank you so much, Murr, for creating the software that you all played the quiz on this evening. We'll be back on Wednesday. Until then, be well, everybody. Can't wait to see you then. Take care.